the bell in round number one.
Starts off with a big head kick, lands on Doliguez.
This fight is brought to you by Papa Rich, all over the world to let you taste pure white coffee. Make no mistake, Doliguez wants to keep this fight standing as well. He feels his boxing, and his boxing alone is going to see him through to victory. And he wants everything off of the jab. From the southpaw stance, snaps the right jab, then the left hook to the body just misses.
See, Shibuya is a crowd entertainer. He likes to entertain. He likes to do what the crowd wants, and the crowd wants to see these guys stand here and throw hands with each other. So he might give them that, knowing that he has distinct advantage on the ground.
Shibuya standing very tall. Now the level change, it hits the takedown.
And it looks like Doliguez might have a small little cut on the top of his forehead, if not the left eye.
Doliguez closed guard. He said, if I'm down, I'm going to work to get up. I do not want to stay on my back exactly where he is. He said, I'll defend submissions by punches. Trying to defend the bottom position with punches now.
See, this is where Shibuya really has a strong advantage in this fight. You know, he just has so much more experience on the ground than Doliguez does.
Doliguez looking the cage walk. Now back to close guard. Short right hands from Riku Shibuya. Short and sharp. Repositioning of the ankle, still closed guard for Doliguez. See the smart base on top from Shibuya, posturing onto his knee.
See, there's that slight little tiny cut on the bridge of Doliguez's nose. Not gonna obstruct the vision at all, unless it starts to run down into his eye because of the pressure that he's kind of upside down there against the cage. See, but Doliguez doesn't need to keep that closed guard, Sean. He needs to let go of the closed guard and try to get up. He doesn't, I mean, he's just basically locking himself into that position.
Now walking up the guard is Doliguez. Crowd reacting, not in triangle choke position, however. Doliguez walking his guard back down.
So you can see his legs are kind of moving up and down Shibuya's body. So you can start at the bottom and then he tries to get up into the shoulders more or into the upper lats right underneath the armpits because there's a possible submission there. It's easier to get your triangles. It's easier to get a possible arm bar. If I see Roy Doliguez throw up a triangle attempt, that'll be one of the more shocking things that I've seen tonight. And we've seen a lot of action here tonight.
Doliguez continuing the punch from the bottom. And even when you're a high-level former professional boxer, knocking out your opponent from the bottom, virtually impossible, even with 4-ounce MMA gloves. Shibuya feeling very confident, basing on his knee. Now again, a big wide stance.
Yeah, Shibuya's got to get active here. He's got it, and that's kind of what Doliguez may be hoping for. He's trying to hand fight and control the hands to possibly get a stand-up. But you can just see the inexperience of Doliguez. He's got to let go of that open guard and try to get up.
Shibuya now attacking the ribs with the right hand.
There he goes. He's trying to transition into a possible heel hook there. That was there.
But that's just not going to happen for Doliguez.
Doliguez trying to turn, trying to explode back to his feet. Now trying to sit up and through, and you see how sticky Riku Shibuya is. To the half guard now of Doliguez. Exactly where Roy Doliguez does not want to be, on his back, now posturing to his hip.
And that's the right idea. You want to turn onto your side when you're in the half guard. The half guard means you just have one leg of your opponent.
50 seconds remaining, round number one.
Now he's popped that leg out, it looks like it. Doliguez trying to fight back, he get
on
the guard.
To finish.
He's still in the half guard position.
You just heard the call for action from referee Peter Ja.
30 seconds to go and Doliguez works back into full guard. Doliguez possibly has an arm bar there. He's got both arms locked against his chest. If he throws one leg over the face of Shibuya, there could be an arm bar there. There he goes. Oh, almost.
So Doliguez though, just a very high guard.
Lots of seconds, fighters.
More final action. Seconds now, round number one. Riku Shibuya in control versus Roy Doliguez here in Changsha, China.
Stop! Fuck!
This fight is brought to you by Papa Rich all over the world to let you taste pure white coffee. There's the jab from the southpaw, stance for Doliguez. Swing and a miss with the left hand. Shibuya was just off balance.
Yeah, a little bit of a slip there. No real damage. Doliguez didn't cause the stumble there by Shibuya. Both fighters a little bit timid here. I think Shibuya's just kind of respecting the power of Doliguez. And Doliguez might be a little bit timid. It's really let go of the striking because he knows the takedown is there. When you see high-level strikers, high-level strikers really get taken down, they get kind of insecure down there. They don't want to let go of the strikes because they fear the possibility of getting taken down again.
You can see the difference in the stance, the posture. Shibuya much more straight up and down. And also look at the hand positioning. Hands high and tight, well-disciplined for Doliguez. Shibuya, his hands out, looking for a level change, looking for a shot. Just like that. There's the sprawl from Doliguez and the commitment to the takedown from Riku Shibuya. And back we go to close guard of Doliguez, and back we go to he's flat on his back. Now the left hands, the jackhammer lefts coming from Shibuya.
See, Doliguez is athletic enough. He is explosive enough to really let go of this position and try to create a scramble. He might not be able to, you know, match technically the Brazilian jiu-jitsu or the ground game of Shibuya, but he is athletic enough to start something, to create a scramble and possibly end up in a better position. When he locks himself into the guard position where he has both legs around Shibuya's body, there's not much he can do except try to block the punches coming from Shibuya.
Riku Shibuya, as we said at the top of this bout, promised a quick knockout win, but this a much smarter strategy. Level changes, takedowns, and then top control.
Yeah, you know, this is definitely where he is gonna have the advantage. You know, it's gonna be on the ground. He picks him up and he kind of helps him up out of the guard position on that time.
He's perhaps looking for a power bomb, and Doliguez got his feet under him. Now the separation.
Nice little move, and Shibuya's got his hands low. You know, you can see Doliguez got his hands nice and tight. Nice little body shot there on the right hook.
Swing to miss again, the level change. And Shibuya content to get back to his feet, didn't follow through. Doliguez to the body.
He's really attacking that body with those big hooks. He's not really setting him up, he's kind of throwing his one shots, which is surprising. The level of striking that Doliguez has. If you put those jabs behind and then attack the body to get Shibuya's hands up a little bit.
Doliguez keeps pumping the jab. This is with the left. This is with
that right
to the body. Call for action again from referee Peter Ja.
Nice little jab. That was nice. Nice little jab, popped the chin up and followed it up with a right kick.
Shibuya with straight punches. This is with that kick to the body, then lands with that short right hook.
I'm a little bit surprised as the flat-footedness of Doliguez. He's not on his toes, he's not bouncing around. It's easy for Shibuya to get in there. He's almost a stationary target, whether he's striking or to take down.
Slick by Riku Shibuya off the Doliguez sprawl, and then he sucked his opponent into him and again has top position. And Doliguez again going back to close guard. You see Roy Doliguez trying to be active from the bottom, he's trying to be active with punches rather than positioning, Mitch.
You know, it's like you said, I mean, he has power in his hands, but if you can't put your hips behind it, you're really just distracting your opponent or annoying your opponent that's on top, which is who's landing much bigger shots.
45 seconds remaining, round number two. Shibuya trying to open up with ground and pound, now standing up again. Just no fear of being caught in a triangle. You see Shibuya very confidently moving. No fear because Doliguez not throwing up the triangle.
Well, there's no attempts, he's not threatening any sort of you know, possible submission off of his back. So, and he's not really doing damage from the bottom. You know, the only strike that's gonna do damage from the bottom is gonna be the elbows. You know, those can cut from the bottom. You know, those can hurt.
Armbar position there for Doliguez, and he did not attempt it. Still Shibuya, more punches from the top. There's the bell, the end of round two.
With the no weight cut policy and this new revolutionary weigh-in procedure, we're seeing a dramatically different type of fighter that's fighting at their optimum performance.
Yeah, I'll tell you, when both fighters aren't cutting weight, though, it becomes relative to each other because now they both have energy, and so they're still wearing each other out. But they're opening up in the third round here with a great pace.
This fight is brought to you by Papa Rich, all over the world to let you taste pure white coffee.
Yeah, Doliguez might sense the urgency here. He's starting to step up his pace. You can just see his tempo is just a little bit quicker as Shibuya shoots in and drags him back down.
Short takedown after the initial sprawl on the single leg. Shibuya so tight, so heavy in that top position. Doliguez just simply no answers from the bottom.
But Shibuya's really not even trying to pass the guard. You know, normally you see if you're in the full guard position, you start pushing down on the knee to really open up the guard and create space to possibly pass and get into a more dominant position. But Shibuya's just very comfortable staying in the top position, in Doliguez's guard, and just, you know, patty cake punching. You know, not really landing any big shots, not really trying to cause big damage with elbows, keeping his head buried in his chest, and just landing shots enough to score and really just secure the fight so far.
Doliguez just parked in that closed guard. 90 seconds gone, third and final round.
In a situation like this, you really gotta work for the finish. You gotta always be trying to finish the fight in the most dramatic way possible. And it's like these guys are almost fighting to win the decision.
See if Riku Shibuya, feeling very good about things in this third and final round, opens it up a bit, looks for the finish. If he's just content to hold top position and to continue to dominate this fight without really threatening a finish.
See, Roy needs to, he's got to understand the circumstance at which he's in. He has been dominated for the past 12 minutes. He's got to try to get up and let those hands go because there's no possible way he is going to win a decision. He's got to let it, he's got to get up.
And Mitch, you hit on it right there. His key to victory at this stage of the fight is on the feet, to utilize the boxing and find the knockout sequence. He's not going to find it on his hip and on his back. Holding tenaciously that closed guard, and that's playing right into the game plan of Riku Shibuya. Shibuya being active enough, continuing the throw, satisfying referee Peter Ja.
See, there he goes. I mean, Doliguez has got to take this back to the drawing board. He's got to get with some strong wrestling coaches, some strong grappling coaches, and really work on the other aspects of his game, because right there, he could have moved, he could have scrambled, he could have pushed away, created space, and moved away to get back up. But he just went right back into full guard, just kind of limiting the damage that he can take.
We're seeing no attempts of sweeps, no butterfly, half butterfly guard for Roy Doliguez, no open guard. Now trying to cage walk, but back to close guard.
And this is what we've seen with a lot of boxers. Once they get on the ground, once when they get put on the floor, they have no idea what they're doing. You know, and when you're that high level of a striker, it will give you so much confidence if you could stop a takedown and know what you're doing on the ground and just let your hands go.
Shibuya opening up that right hand and another. A bit more force behind those two punches.
But you gotta wonder, with the inexperience of Doliguez on the ground, why is Shibuya not trying to pass this guard and possibly work to finish on the ground?
I think the answer is that Shibuya feels great about this position, feels very comfortable. He's not being threatened from the bottom game of Doliguez. He's being active, now landing that left hand into the 15th and final minute of this flyweight bout.
Last 45 seconds here. Let's see if we can make something happen. Because right now, Doliguez is just holding him and just taking bombs. Because these shots, these are going to add up over time, and they're going to hurt. You know, he's bleeding already a little bit.
Doliguez talked all about winning this bout with his superior hands, his superior boxing, his accuracy in striking, but he spent the vast majority of the bout on his back with just simply no answer for the top game and the pressure of Riku Shibuya.
But it's hard, Sean, to get really let your hands go when you're scared to be taken down. If you know you're gonna end up on your back and suffer through, you know, I mean, how many minutes was that? Probably 13, 12 minutes that he spent on his back. You know, you just won't want to let your hands go because you're afraid that somebody's gonna shoot in and take you down.
For your winner, via unanimous decision, from the blue corner, Riku Shibuya!
Riku Shibuya, the multiple Muay Thai world champion and former one strawweight world champion. Dejdamrong, Saranmoy Sirajai. Shibuya is in southpaw stance. Look for the right cross, the right round kicks, and the right elbows of Dejdamrong. Inside leg kick from Shibuya.
Since going to Hawaii, we've seen really just Shibuya change his entire style. He used to come out with a much, you know, wider karate-based stance. Now he's got his hands up, more Muay Thai-based.
Cracking roundhouse kick there from Dejdamrong Saranmoy Sirajai.
He's got to be careful. He doesn't want to eat too many of those. You can see his elbows are kind of flared out, so that opens up his body to that right round kick.
Oh, the high kick! And Shibuya leans back like Fat Joe to evade it. Inside leg kick from Shibuya. Dejdamrong, so slick. There is nothing in the striking world that Dejdamrong hasn't seen before. And that's why Shibuya shoots in for a single leg and hopes for a takedown. What's Dej trying to do here, Mitch?
He was threatening to possibly keep Kimura, but he chose to let that go. Now, this is where we're seeing the really evolution of Shibuya, this grinding, grappling style. He likes to slowly work his way up into the mount and just punish his opponents.
Inside the half guard, looking to posture up and work the ground and pound. Dejdamrong trying to get back to his feet. Oh, the choke attempt from Shibuya! Is Dej in trouble here?
He was for just a second, but he managed to get his leg out. Look at how easily Dej gets back up to his feet. Tries to jump over the side, but gets caught in the guard of Shibuya.
Shibuya resetting the choke, closes up the guard. Glances towards his corner. There's a good view of Dej and how he looks at the moment. The neck is trapped. He tries to bang his way out. And Shibuya resets again, closes the guard once more. This is where Riku Shibuya wants to be.
I like how Dej is trying to jump out of the guard there, but he's kind of jumping into the wrong area. He's got to kind of go the other way.
Yuji Shimada asking Dej if he's okay to go on. Shibuya gives the referee a crazy-eyed look. One butterfly guard on the left leg. Now a full close guard again. Is Dej stuck here? Can he get out of this predicament? Shibuya squeezing. You see the veins in the forearm. Oh, he's forced to tap out. Shibuya tapped him out. The veteran's experience on the ground coming through.
He was able to adjust that guillotine and find just the right position. Once he was able to, he kept it locked up for a long time, slowly making adjustments like an anaconda. And once he got that one that he wanted, there was no place for Dej to go except to tap his way home.
Mitch, was that sheer experience advantage there from Riku Shibuya?
That's high-level grappling. To have the guillotine in for such a long time and just to make minute adjustments, very impressive.
Did Dejdamrong make any cardinal mistakes here, Mitch?
See, there he is, right there. He jumped into the wrong way. He was out. He was not in the close guard there of Shibuya, but he jumped into the close guard, and that pretty much was it. And Shibuya was just able to cinch it in tighter and tighter.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.